Hello everybody, welcome to the JavaScript course. In this video, I'm going to tell you the ways to set up a variable in JavaScript. So this video is divided into 5 parts. The first part is to simply let a variable, and then we can do the assignment of a value to a variable. And then we can also discuss the way to copy a variable to another variable. And I'm going to show you the naming rules of the variables. And finally, I'm going to discuss a little bit about the constant variable issue. Now, let me show you the HTML file first. So this HTML file is a very simple one. I simply include a script in the body part so that I'm going to link this JavaScript file to the HTML file. And this JavaScript file is placed inside the JS folder, which is at the same level of the HTML file. So I'm going to handle the JavaScript file now. Of course, we have to use strict, so that I'm going to use the strict mode of JavaScript language. When we simply want to name a variable, we usually use the camel case notation for JavaScript. So what does it mean by the camel case notation? Let me show you an example. Now, when I want to set up a variable, I need to use the let keyword before the variable name. And now I simply put a semicolon just after the variable name. And the variable name has a property like this one. The first letter is a small letter. And when we want to join another word to the variable, we start that word with the capital letter. So capital G here means the beginning of the word greeting. And when I want to join my and greeting together, I'm going to change the first G to the capital letter so that the camel case convention is achieved. Okay. Now here we haven't assigned any value to this variable yet. So if I really display the value of the variable, I will expect some situation as follows. So let me save it and reload the page. You will see that the variable is simply called undefined. So when I haven't put any value to the variable content is called undefined. So we haven't done any real assignment yet. Okay. Now I want to put a string into the variable called my greeting. So now the assignment is done. This string is put into the variable. So let me save it and show the result coming from the variable called my greeting in the form of an alert window. Okay, you see that the alert window can show the string content called nice to meet you, which is the variable content of the variable called my greeting. Okay. So this situation means that the real assignment is achieved. In addition to doing the assignment in another row, we can simply combine the naming of the variable together with the assignment together. Okay, here I get the name of a variable, and then I set the value of this variable directly. So this string, how are you doing, is put to the variable called my greeting too. Okay. Now let me save it. And after setting up the alert window, I'm able to show the content of the variable. How are you doing is shown in the alert window. Okay. So this kind of combination of the variable naming and the assignment action is quite common in JavaScript. So you can just use one row to complete the naming and the assignment. Okay. I'm going to show you the way to copy the content of a variable to another one. So what does it mean by the copying action? Let me show you an example here. This statement is simply saying that I'm setting up a variable called myGreeting3, which is having the same value as the content of myGreeting2. So I can simply print out by using an alert window. Save it, reload the page. Okay, the content is simply the same as myGreeting2. So myGreeting3 is also how are you doing by doing the copying action of the variable content to another variable name. So how about the situation when I changed myGreeting2? I can show you the situation right now. Now after the copying action, I want to change the original variable called myGreeting2 to another string. And what will happen when I want to print out both greeting2 and greeting3? Let me show you now. Save it. Reload the page. I'm okay is printed out because myGreeting2 is really having a content called I'm okay. And myGreeting3 isn't changed after its copying action is done. So even though myGreeting2 is changed later, myGreeting3 isn't affected because this copy action is done before the assignment of a new value to the original variable called greeting2. Okay. So we can see that the two variables are separate after the copying action of the content from one variable to another one. So the value is unaffected. Okay. In addition to starting with letters, a variable can also start with an underline and a dollar sign. So what does it mean by this one? We can see an example right now. So the underline is simply a variable name. I put 9 to the underline variable. The dollar sign is simply having a value of 7. And when we want to do the assignment in one line, we can use a comma to separate each of the assignments. Okay. Also, I want to set a variable called number whose value is 3. So when I want to do the addition of the three variables, I will expect that a number will come out, which is the sum of the three variable contents. Okay? Save it and reload the page. 19 is given out because 19 is obtained by adding 9, 7, and 3 together. And I'm going to tell you the situation when I want to set up a constants variable. So what does it mean by a constant variable? It is a variable that cannot change itself after its assignment. So my name is called John Smith. So when I set the variable to be constant, it is impossible for me to change the content later. In order to prove this one, I have to show the alert window again first. Save it. Reload the page. Okay, the content is shown. And how about changing the variable content now? So let me save it and try to reload the page. You'll see when I click on the reload button, I'm unable to show the content because I wanted to set up a new value to a constant variable, which is not allowed. So we have to notice that a constant variable can never be reassigned after its value is fixed, okay? So when I simply ignore this line by commenting it, I'm able to show the alert window again. save, reload. Okay, John Smith is given out. So the content of the my name variable is shown up here. Okay. So this video has already discussed a lot of points to consider when we set up a variable. We have to give the name first, and sometimes we can also simply give the value of the variable at the same time. And the copying action of the variables can be done very easily by doing a simple assignment. Okay, and the variable names can start with letters, and the underscore together with the dollar sign. And when we want to assign a constant variable, we have to make sure that it can never change later. If you want to change it, you don't use the const keyword. This is the end of the video. If you have any questions about my video, please leave your questions on the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.